Beyonce at the United Center tonight. I guess the first big moment in the show was Michelle Obama showing up with her two daughters. So you knew it was kind of a pretty big night. And interesting that it was the three female members of the top family in the White House. It was not not the president himself, and pretty much a girls' night out for a lot of people there. I saw a guy in the washroom ahead of time. He says, "What are you doing here?" I says, "Sometimes you got to take one for the team, right?" It's one of those things where the guys were definitely playing second fiddle to their dates tonight. Very much a girl power kind of show. And Beyonce played to that. She knows that's the kind of icon she is. She said, "You know, I'm a feminist. I'm a modern day feminist." And a lot of her songs since Destiny's Child have been addressing that issue. And the song was basically about female empowerment in a really positive way. You know, not over the top theatrics. There's many shows that I've seen on the pop culture scale where there was a lot more going on in terms of things blowing up and extra props. She had some of that. She zipped from one end of the arena to the other on a zip line. So she basically transferred stages from the main stage up front to a secondary stage in the middle of the audience on this zip line. But that was really the only sort of theatrical element of the show. A lot of it was just about bonding with her largely female audience. Well, she set up some of the elements of the show that she played at the United Center at the Super Bowl. You could sort of see some of those elements in the show. There was that guitar solo, if you remember, with the sparklers coming out of the guitar, and she had that element. The female band that she had at the Super Bowl, you know, we talk about this being sort of a female-centric show. The 11-piece band that she had at the Super Bowl was the same band that played at the United Center, and all women in the band. All but two of her dancers were women, so it was basically the same kind of core lineup that she had. She hasn't had a new album since 2011, so she's performing largely material that is well known to her fans. She didn't preview any of the material of this record that she's working on. So yeah, it was basically a longer version. It was a 2-hour version of that 12-minute halftime show in a lot of ways. My daughter and I were both watching the show very intently, we're trying to quizzing each other. Does it look like she's lip-syncing at all? Because obviously that's an element in some of these big shows, you know. And we've seen that before, obviously, even with some of the most notable singers, you know, Christina Aguilera, Madonna, whatever. Not that Madonna's noted for her singing, but you know, the presentation is such that you're expecting live, but you're not always getting live in a lot of these big shows. I would say Beyonce was pretty much singing in the moment. I mean, there was clearly backing tracks being used, but there was also a sense that she was singing live to the microphone. And, you know, her voice sounded pretty good. I don't think there was any actual huge missteps in the show. The pacing was reasonably good for somebody who's changes costumes so much. There were no really super flat notes or like, oh, that was an awful performance. I do think the show still very choreographed. She has elements of spontaneity in her show, engaging the audience. I would have loved to have seen more of that because I think she's got that in her to take it out of the realm of this kind of choreographed, almost big Broadway style production into something a little bit more intimate. And there were moments of that in this show. And when she did that, the show worked the best it did all night. It was the elements where you felt everything was sort of on remote control a little bit, where you felt a little bit more distant from the performer and that she wasn't really separating herself from the pack as well as she might have.